The FBI has arrested an Ohio man for plotting an attack on the U.S. Capitol building. His plan was to set off pipe bombs inside and then gun down as many government officials as he could.
20-year-old Christopher Cornell expressed support for ISIS on Twitter, but he's described as a lone wolf with no formal ties to any terror group. Caitlin Burke brings us the story.
An Ohio man is behind bars today, accused of plotting a homegrown terror attack. Authorities say he wanted to wage jihad in the U.S., inspired by Al-Qaeda and ISIS.
You wouldn't think Cincinnati, Ohio, jihadist in the same sentence.
According to the FBI, the plan was a deadly assault on the U.S. Capitol building and members of Congress. The suspect was arrested Wednesday after buying two M15 assault rifles and 600 rounds of ammunition. He's identified as 20-year-old Christopher Lee Cornell. Authorities say he publicly supported the Islamic State, and he'd been posting disturbing messages on Twitter. One stated, "I believe we should just wage jihad under our own orders and plan attacks." A beginner's hand guide to Islam was among the things taken from Cornell's apartment.
He had just recently converted to Islam, and he had been talking about it for a few months. He's a good kid. He's been kind of lost.
Meanwhile, Nigeria's homegrown Islamic extremist group Boko Haram is also acting more like ISIS, declaring an Islamic caliphate and launching widespread attacks across countries in East Africa. Girls as young as 10 are being used as suicide bombers, and the number of attacks is increasing. In one of their most recent attacks, jihadis massacred up to 2,000 people. Despite the deadly terrorism in Paris and the Muslim attacks and violence around the world, the White House refuses to use the words radical Islam to describe the terrorist, even when they themselves say they're acting on behalf of Islam and Muhammad. Caitlin Burke, CBN News.
I don't agree with this newspeak coming out of the White House. Put it in other terms, what do you think of when you hear the term radical Baptist or radical Catholic? What do you think of? You certainly don't think of somebody trying to plot an attack on the U.S. Capitol. There's a reason Islam seems to spontaneously produce this kind of behavior, and you find it in the words of the Quran. That's the source, and Jesus told us to judge trees by their fruit, and this is the fruit of Islam. In other news, the United States is battling a major flu epidemic. Here's John Jessup with more on how to fight it. John?
Gordon, the flu epidemic is so severe that the Centers for Disease Control says it's widespread in almost every state. And as Lori Johnson reports, new antiviral medicines could make the difference between life and death.
Nearly 30 children have died from the flu so far this season, including 5-year-old Scarlett Taylor of Tacoma, Washington.
I feel like, you know, if I would have known more about this flu, you know, maybe I would have taken her to the doctors on Wednesday instead of Friday.
The flu vaccine does not protect against the strain of flu Scarlett had, H3N2, which is sweeping the country.
Antiviral medications like Tamiflu and Relenza can reduce the severity of the flu. There are a couple catches. You need a prescription, and you should start taking them within 2 days of developing symptoms.
Flu symptoms include fever, aches, and fatigue. People who benefit the most from antivirals are those at greatest risk of dying from the flu, people over 65 and the very young. Also, folks with chronic issues like diabetes, asthma, and heart disease.
To prevent catching the flu in the first place, wash your hands and load up on vitamins through food, supplements, or both. Lori Johnson, CBN News.
In other health news, not getting enough exercise could be twice as deadly as being obese. Researchers at Cambridge University in Britain studied information from more than 330,000 European men and women and found that twice as many deaths were linked to a lack of exercise compared to obesity. But they also found just a little bit of exercise, like 20 minutes or more of walking, can seriously cut the risks of early death, especially for people who already spend much of their time sitting. And if you can't walk 20 minutes at a time, experts recommend splitting it up 10 minutes twice a day. Well, those are today's top stories from CBN News.